How to put on personal protective equipment using a case of suspected COVID-19 as an example. In this video, we will use healthcare equipment with particular design features. The equipment used in this video may differ from that available to you. The proper method of putting on personal protective equipment will be demonstrated by Daniel and Marie. Daniel will engage in patient contact, so he will need to put on personal protective equipment. Marie will assist him. Eventually, you should be able to put on protective clothing without assistance. First, arrange the necessary protective equipment. This includes protective gown, respiratory mask. Here, we will be using a mask with N95 equivalent filtration, eye protection, glasses or visor, properly sized disposable gloves, sufficient disinfectant. A protective hood can also be worn if available. This can be especially helpful for procedures such as intubations or bronchoscopies, which are associated with aerosol formation. Remove any jewelry and tie your hair back. Once again, check that all necessary materials are present. One last tip. It can get warm quickly under protective clothing, so make sure you have drunk enough fluids before putting on protective clothing. The next step is hand disinfection. Collect 2 to 3 pumps of disinfectant from a dispenser. Thoroughly rub the liquid into both dry hands. Take care not to leave out the fingertips, gaps between the fingers, or wrists. A thorough hand disinfection takes about 30 seconds. Now, proceed to putting on the protective gown. This step can be done on your own or with the help of an assistant. First, put on the gown. The closed side of the gown faces the patient. The next step is to close the neck band. If a gown with an inner band is used, it should remain open. The waist-level closure should be fastened at either side. Now, proceed to putting on the breathing mask. Important information for those who wear glasses. Before putting on the mask, take off your glasses and clean them if necessary. The breathing mask must be put on very carefully. Extra care is needed for bearded individuals, as beard hair can interfere with sealing the edges of breathing masks. Patient contact should only take place if the care provider has been properly trained in mask fitting and is satisfied that the mask is fitted correctly. Daniel will now show you how to put on the breathing mask. The respirator shown here is an N95 equivalent mask. First, put on the mask so that the nose, mouth, and chin are completely covered. Next, the nose clip should be fitted to the bridge of the nose with both index fingers. The breathing mask's elastic bands should be tight enough to securely fit onto the head. The upper band should be placed in a secure position above your ears. The lower band should be located at the neck. Now, check whether the breathing mask is fitted tightly. In the case of a mask without a valve, exhale quickly to check the fit. The mask is correctly fitted if there is no air leakage at the edge of the mask. To check the fit of a mask with a valve, inhale deeply. If the mask fits correctly, it will collapse somewhat against your face. Now for putting on eye protection. People who wear glasses should now put them back on. Eye protection should be placed over one's own glasses if necessary. When applying a visor, you should ensure that it covers the entire face, including the chin area. Next, put on properly sized disposable gloves. Make sure that the gloves cover your wrists. Before contact with a patient, make sure that the protective equipment fits properly. An assistant can support you if necessary. It is now possible to carry out protected patient contact. Throughout your contact with the patient, always make sure that your personal protective equipment is fitted correctly.